My first stop is the Castaway Rays Stingray Adventure. And we're gonna feed some fish, and Tanya here is gonna navigate me through all this. Tanya, tell me about this program.
This is an hour-long excursion we have here on the island, and people can come and learn a little bit about stingrays. Then they get to get in the water and get up close and personal, pet and feed them, and then they can snorkel in our lagoon.
Right. Tell me first, where do you get your stingrays from?
These are all southern stingrays. It's a very common species around the Caribbean, so we actually collect all of these girls right off the island here.
How many do you have, and males, females, what do you have here?
We have 45 total, 42 females and 3 boys.
Why so many females and so few males?
Generally, for southern stingrays, there aren't as many males. They have no parental care absolutely at all, so when the females have their pups, the babies are called pups, okay. They go off on their own, so they don't need as many males to impregnate all
okay.
the females.
Okay. And this, what is this little contraption here? Tell me
this
about
is this. What we've built. This is what we call an interaction station. So okay. the rays have been trained. It's kind of like a drive-through.
And they know.
Exactly. We have ramps that go in on both sides, and they're trained to come up one end and swim through the other. And they're target trained over our Mickey Mouse head here.
Oh, wow.
They okay. stop over the Mickey face, and then they can swim through when they're done feeding.
Now that one has said, now I'm going back out here. Now, and how do you train them to do this? Is it only when the ship is docked, or what is your program?
No, we train them 6 days a week. Their schedule is they do get fed 7 times a day, 6 days a week. So we just keep them on that regular schedule so that when the guests do come in here, the rays are already used to getting fed. They're very well trained.
I love this. And what are we feeding them today?
All right, we have a couple different things here. Get my plates. Show you. We have restaurant quality shrimp and also some calamari.
Wow.
And this is the vitamin stingray gel that we make here on the island. It's got different vitamin supplements in there for them. Kind of keeps their diet a little bit more well-rounded. Yeah. What we're going to do is we're going to use this plate here. So what we have people do is put their hand really flat, pinch any piece of food they want between their fingers, and put your hand flat on that target. Yeah, just put your hand real flat, push all your fingers down.
It's quite slimy.
Yeah, it's a little bit slippery. They have a vacuum-like suction, so they have a pretty good pull. So you want to make sure your fingers are pushed down on that plate. Like, wait a minute. There we go.
Oh, okay. Oh my goodness. That is a suction.
Yeah, it's very strong.
That's enough. Oh, okay. Yes.
Try again.
Same thing. All right. Okay. It is something to keep this here because it's very slimy.
We try and cut the gel into smaller strips so it's easier to hold.
Oh! That's a weird sensation. Now, if you let it go, will they'll still find
they'll
it?
Still they'll find it.
They'll still
yeah.
find it. Okay.
Yeah.
And do you know who's who?
Yeah, we do.
How can you tell the males from the females? Oh, okay.
Males are easy to tell apart from females. Generally,
can I
they're
touch
smaller.
It?
Yeah, you can touch her.
They're so incredibly soft.
Generally, the males won't get any bigger than this ray. This is Rainbow Bright, also it's a female, but males won't get much bigger than her size right there.
Okay.
They also have what are called claspers, that are two finger-like looking things that come off the back of the base of the tail.
The males will have that.
The males have them, the females don't.
Very informative. Thank you so much, Tanya.
Sure, no
appreciate
problem.
It.